Thank you.
Thank you, Zoom. Good evening, everyone. Really excited to do this call with you all tonight because I actually did this today. I think it's really needed, and I think sometimes we don't use the tools that Herbalife actually gives us to track our business and plan our month and everything. So on the Go Get group, you would have seen that I posted the house plan for you all. Thank you, Elsa, for sending it through to me. There is, I know Karina has got a very fancy one on Excel. If she wants to, she can maybe share it with you all. If you are an Excel person, I am a printed out type of person. I need to see it. I need to work on the paper and just stick it up in front of me, and I need to see it, because if it's on the computer, I forget about it completely. So tonight, what I want to go through.
Are you a baby boomer that you want to have it on paper?
I am a baby boomer. I am. Are you a baby boomer?
I am.
You're a boomer. I'm a millennial, but then I'm partly baby boomer. but so what I want to do with you all tonight is, when you look at this and when I go through the training, and it's actually amazing how perfect this slots into what Laverne literally just said. We're just going to take it up a notch. Think about your team while I do this, and think about people in your organization, and Elsa or Karina or someone who has used the house plan a few times before. If you guys want to pitch in and say something, you are more than welcome to. So, first of all, your personal use. And I know a lot of house plans, I know Peter has one where the personal use, the PPV, is the foundation of the house. And I actually like that, because everything starts with your foundation and everything starts with your personal use. And just like Laverne just said, she said, make sure that your results are impeccable and your results are key. So what is your body goal for the month? I am doing this cleanse now with all these crazy 100 people on the group, and I really want to break my 70 kgs, and I just want to give my body a kickstart, and then I'll go from there again. So that is my personal goal, and I'm going to track my journey on social media. I'm going to track my journey with my customers one-on-one. All of my cleanses, I checked today, I think I've got 15 people cleansing with me in my team. One brand new lady, but she's incorporating a little bit of protein during the day as well, like Elsa just showed us that you can incorporate a little bit of protein. It's not total cleansing, but whatever. The person, the newbie, is still fine. They're not going to hate Herbalife forever. But so that is my personal goal and my personal use for the month. And I am going to up my personal use, and this month I'm going to try a new product. So I'm thinking of, I've tried everything already, but thinking of adding something else to my cart now with my next order, and just getting some new results on that. Like, I've tried Pro 20 last month, just trying to get new results on a new product. So what's yours? Because it starts with personal, guys. It starts with us. We can't put everything on the team. Okay. So next room, room A, is your new customer room. So what you can do there is all your new customers, you start writing them in there. But what I want to challenge you is, give yourself a number, maybe right there in the corner. I want to get 5 new customers this month. So that means one and a little bit of customers in a week, like Laverne said, 1.3 or 1.1. You want to break it up for yourself weekly, so that you weekly work on a weekly small goal, not have a huge goal that you have to achieve in the last week of the month before you wakker geskrik het. So every week, try to get yourself a new goal. So what is your customer goal? What are you busy advertising? Are you advertising the 10-day breakthrough? Are you advertising the 21-day challenge? So currently, the 10-day breakthrough is starting the 17th. So we have another 3-4 days to get people in there. So maybe advertise that. Put your status full of that. Maybe focus on that. Or if you are someone who uses the 21-day challenge as a platform in your business, start advertising today. I already started advertising my 21-day challenge today because I'm really aiming to get at least 10 new people into my 21-day challenge.
I'm going to focus on that tomorrow. I'm going to focus tomorrow morning on the daily post, action post to be on the Breakfast Club. So I'll share that and the script in the morning.
Awesome. There, guys, you're going to get some value. I don't know if you saw, we are all the leaders in the group. We are going to start posting something every morning for you to go do if you wanted to. Use it or not use it. I did mine this morning. Your Elsa's of a Tuesday. I had to take the wonderful Monday. I didn't do it before 8 o'clock. I'm sorry. But it's done. So what are you busy advertising? What promo do you have for it? What value are you adding? Do you want to give an early bird? I'm thinking of doing like a 21 days combo. And if you book all your 21 days or you pay for your 21 days before, let's say the 20th, then if you take maybe a stamp, I'll give you your multi-fiber for free or whatever. All of us are supervisors here. So we have our products on 50%. And it's a nice way to get in more customers and have them try another product to increase their results. A free product with a certain combo. So what are you thinking about? What would you enjoy? And if you wonder about a freebie or you wonder about something, go ask your current customers. Ask them, listen, if I had to give a freebie, what would you enjoy? If I had to give you something extra, would you like discount on your products? Would you like a freebie? Would you like a one-on-one Zoom with me? What would you like? Go find out from your customers what their needs are and then incorporate that into your business. Okay, so room B is your repeated customer. So that's last month's customers. Go write their names down, sorry. And then go see where are they currently at and where are they slotting in? What are their goals? How are you busy supporting them? Are you checking in with them daily, every second day, every third day? Remember to treat these customers like gold. There's fortune in the follow-up. You already did hard work to get them as a customer. Now you have to keep them. And that's even harder work. So how do you plan to upgrade them? What I do a lot is if I have a customer, I just want to mute everyone here, guys. I've got a lot of discount customers in my organization. So I would see that they're constantly maybe buying 90 volume or 100 volume. Then I would go ask them, how are you doing? Which flavors did you try? So I just know where they are currently. And then I would put out for them like a small 150 PPV promo for them personally, just to see if they can up their game. And then I would encourage them to try something new, try a different flavor, try a different product. I will encourage them to go look at the skin range or the hair care range, just to introduce them to the other things. Like Laverne just said, make sure your customers know if they buy from their own shop, they're busy accumulating volume to reach 50% eventually. So they're busy accumulating volume monthly. And they just need a minimum of 334 volume points monthly to reach supervisor at the end of the year. Who's unmuting himself all the time here? There we go. Okay. So, how are you planning to upgrade them? And sometimes with a customer, if they're close, I add an extra protein bar or a bag of lift off or anything like that to their bag when I go drop it off. Just to have them experience more of the other products. And you guys have heard this, but if my customers are far and they bought, let's say, a 2,000 rands worth of products, then I'll add a bar of soap in there, or I'll always try to add a product that's not very expensive for me, but something that will introduce them to something else in our product range. And then with your customers, ask them for referrals and ask them to write reviews on you, because this is something key in our business, guys. You'll see so many more people coming to you, asking you if you start showing people the results that your customers are getting and the reviews they're busy writing about you. Okay. So now that is now the customer side. If you look on the right-hand side here by room C, now this is your new distributors. Again, what is your goal for the month? Are you aiming for 3 new people this month? 4 new, 5 new people? Make it an achievable goal for yourself. If you're currently only signing up 1 person every month, make your goal 3 or 4 to not scare yourself and feel that you can't achieve it at all, but that you are still moving up and you're still going towards your goal. Where are you planning to find them? What are you busy advertising? Like we said by the customer, you're actually advertising the exact same thing, because the customers you get in is sometimes the people that you're eventually going to introduce to the business opportunity after they get amazing results. So what is your number of people you're talking to daily? Laverne says it a lot. So what's your number? What's your number? Do you want to talk to 5 new people every day? 3 new people every day? 10 new people every day? Just remember, the amount of people you talk to daily is going to determine how fast your business is going to grow. So if you decide you want to talk to 3 new people daily, that means it's 12, 15 new people in a week, if you just do Monday to Friday. And the chances are that all 15 is going to say yes is not very good. But if you decide you want to talk to 5 new people, that's 20 new people, 25 new people. So the chances of people saying yes just increases. So what is your promo that you put out for your new distributors? So the team promos that we currently run, like you said, saw on the first call, 500 PPV times 3. That is what I usually give, or that is something my almost business builders, people getting a few customers or referrals because of the great results, they can go for that. You can introduce a place your first order gift. Outside a great idea where we can tell the brand new distributor, listen, I'll send you R100, add your pink shaker or your blue shaker with your first order. Just send me the proof of your order, so that you immediately activate a brand new member. Even if they just activate with a tea, even if they just activate with a multi-fiber or protein drink mix, they went onto their website, they went to order. And usually what happens is when they start playing around there, they start seeing the other products. So don't go order for them, show them how to. Go with them on the website, go with them on the Herbalife ordering app, and they will figure it out. Okay. I sometimes put out a small little 250 PPV promo with something small. This is literally for my product lovers. People just using the products, maybe buying a stamp and a half, and then have one of their family members joining. So yeah, it is achievable for them. It stretches them a little bit, but it's still achievable. And what I usually try to give is products so they can try different products. Many times I've added a box of bars or sent a box of bars for a promotion, and the next order they tell me, listen, I couldn't go without it. I need the box of bars, so I'm ordering it for myself this round. So the people really, when they start getting used to the products, they can't leave it. Like us, we can't not do Herbalife. Okay, so room D and E, I just threw together, but obviously keep them separate on your house plan. But how we support them and all of that is exactly the same. So what are you doing with your current senior consultants? Do you know who is a senior consultant in your team at the moment? Your QPs in your team, do you know? How are you supporting them? Are you still treating them as a customer first? Because remember, they also need those product results. I constantly forget to treat my supervisors and my senior consultants and my QPs as a customer. I tend to talk business, because that's their goal. That's what they told me is their goal. But then they get stuck because they're not focusing on their product use anymore. They're focusing on their business. And if you don't have the product use, if you don't have the results, you don't have the business. So make sure you check in with them first. How are you having your shape? What's your goal for the week? How is those pants fitting? stuff like that. First business, first little bit of life, then a little bit of products, then you go into the business side, if that is their goals. So how are you supporting them? Are you doing one-on-ones with them? I've got broadcast lists for most of my senior consultants, or depending on what their goals are. Are they joining 21-day challenges with you? Are they doing 10 days with you? What are they doing? Do you know what their goals, their updated goals are? A while back, I did I think it was last month, Levin, when I had also a survey gedaan, or we spoke about a survey, I quickly just drew up a survey. And I sent a survey to a lot of my people in my team who is not really doing anything. And I thought to myself, I want to know why are they not doing anything? And one of the questions was, I thought I wanted to be a business builder, but actually I just love the products. I would love to be a product lover again, something like that. And all of them clicked that. They thought they wanted to do the business initially, but then they just want to do the products actually. They were head over heels when they started. But now if I can get them on the products, have them use the products, have them get great results from the products, then obviously business is going to happen eventually by itself. But focus on what they want, not what you want. When last did they order? So I literally just pulled my report. And then I go into my BizWorks Plus and I pull a report who ordered in the last 6 months. I print it out for myself and I go through all the names of my whole organization, not just my first lines, of my whole organization. And I make sure when I pull my report, the sponsor name is there and their cell phones are there, just in case I don't have them on my system yet. And what I then do is I just pop them a message and say, listen, I would love to be part of your journey. I see that Chris is your upline. He's an absolutely amazing upline. His results are incredible. So you talk good about their sponsor, because obviously they've built trust in this person already. You don't want to take that role away. But what you want to do is just give them another Herbalife lifeline. You are just another Herbalife lifeline for them, if they're now a second or a third or a fourth line. And talk to them. I see you've ordered last month. How did you enjoy the products? Did you try a 21-day challenge or whatever? So what are you putting out for as a promo for these people, for your senior consultants and your QPs? Are you helping them track their MAP promo, if they're going for the MAP, if they're going for the Leadership Development Weekend? Are they qualified for the Leadership Weekend? These people are, do you want to give them referral gifts? Maybe it's literally just a senior consultant who bought the 500 volume points and now they're just using up the products. What now? What are you going to do with them now? Remember, they've got a whole circle of influence that you can tap into. But you must build that confidence with them, that trust first, and then you can ask them, listen, don't you have a friend or family or someone who might be interested? I need to do 5 evaluations this week. Please help me. Don't you have someone that I can do the evaluations with? Just start getting into their circle of influences. And then lastly, I put the apartment. There isn't a supervisor little group on this house plan, but your supervisors. I think most of you do have a supervisor or 2 or 3, but talk to them personally, check in with them in the beginning of the month, check in them with mid-month. This is now mid-month. Where are their product results? What are their monthly goals? Do they know how to build their house plans? If they're not on this group, are they on the Up the Game group? What are their personal goals in the business? What are their personal goal or their personal body goals as well? How far away are they from the events promo, the Mykonos that we're going to go away for? Did they already qualify for the Leadership Development Weekend? Because remember, supervisors, we also need to qualify. So, so this is an idea of a house plan. Like I mentioned, Karina also has an amazing one. I can ask her if she can just maybe post it on the group if you're like an Excel sheet person. But what I want to encourage you all tonight is go print out your house plan. Go look at every room. What is happening in your business in those rooms? What platforms do you advertise in each of the rooms? How do you support those people? The other day when I pulled my report for the people who ordered in my team, I was surprised because I wasn't talking to some of them and they ordered. So sometimes they just slip by, especially if your team is growing a little bit bigger. So make sure that you constantly pull those BizWorks reports. And if you're not subscribed to BizWorks, go do it tonight because you get 3 months for free. And then it is a tool that you do need. You can't not track your business. And then, with every single group, make sure you know what their goals are. Make sure that they are focused as a customer. Start with a customer focus. And then think about the promotions that's suitable for them with their goals. I have a lot of people who's just product lovers. They only do 80, 90, 100 points. A 500 PPV points promo for them is useless. They won't even look at it. But if I give them a cookbook promo, or if I give them get your free iced coffee promo or whatever, obviously always go make sure the money you spend is not more than the money that you'll get in from the volume that they do. Okay. So if you ever wonder about a promo, if you want to put out a small little mini promo in your team, chat to your sponsor, chat to, I know Elsa is the promo queen, chat to her and ask her, listen, I want to spoil my customers this month. What can I do? How can I do a cost-efficient little promo and introduce more products to them? Elsa, I think I get it gedoen binnen a half year. Do you guys have any questions? What do you guys think? Elsa, do you have anything to add?
No, I think you did a great job. I think the big thing is that we tend to focus often on the new people. We spend a lot of time on customers, especially because we've got so much customer focus. And then we have too many of our 30, like old 35ers and maybe old QPs. Since the company changed it, that once you're a Q qualified producer, maybe you were a supervisor, now you dropped off. And I think one of the important things there is when you see that people are doing consistent volume and suddenly that sort of diminishes, that you then can sort of step in there and try to just live first and find out a little bit what is the case. But as you, my first question is always, how are you doing on the products? Get a new result. And this is why I love this 3-day detox. We've got so many members on there, and I promise you, we're going to have amazing results come out of that. And because everybody is excited, if they are clever, they will get them into the 10 days, and the 10 days finishes up just before the next 21 days comes. So we can really get people to, in a short time, have amazing results. But if the members do it, you've got to get super excited about your own result and, you know, just have that fresh excitement that you get through to the team. But I think this is, how can I say, the diagnostics of the house plan was really years ago from a couple that went to Chairman's Club in a very, very short space of time. So for those of you that don't know the story, they started it by saying that, when you teach somebody to drive a car, you can't get into the car and show them once and then get out. You actually have to teach them the basics of, pushing the first time you got in the car and you had to push the brakes and the clutch and the everything, nothing was natural. You had to think and you were like all over the place. And later on, it just came naturally. You didn't think about it anymore. And this is, we leave our new people too fast. We think they have it and they don't have it yet. And this is what this whole design of the diagnostics of the house plan is all about, because you've got a real figure, you can see it all the time, and this is where the affirmations and the, I can see where I'm at, I can see my goal every month. If I see I want to get 5 to 7 new clients and I'm writing the names down in my house, my little A room, a B room, but it always starts with your own results. So that was great. Thank you so much. And let's all print them up and, you know, sort of really, really refocus with that, because that's going to bring us a balance of our communication to our teams.
Awesome.
Hulle twee het 'n great job gedoen vanaand, hoor.
Levin, ons kan almal vroeg gaan slaap vanaand.
Yeah. Is my short, very short and powerful.
Ja. Is dit die detox wat julle nou so vinnig maak?
We have okay. to run to the bathrooms, yeah.
For those of you that joined us late, we did make a recording, so you can watch the recording as well. I'll download it tomorrow morning. Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.